男人明明是名老实本分的警察，可他却举枪瞄准了路上无辜的行人。紧接着他立即调转枪口，向对面金融大厦看热闹的职员疯狂扣动扳机。尽管林肯打光了所有子弹，但他的复仇之旅才刚刚开始。可究竟是为什么令原本老实本分的林肯突然性情大变？原来就在不久前，他的妻子幸运地被查出患有癌症，好在发现得早，只要得到及时的治疗就能够痊愈。然而这种治疗所需的费用却价格不菲，这时平日里交的医疗保险就起到了作用。但没想到到了保险公司，对方却以预算费用较高拒绝给妻子承担医疗费，也就是保险公司的这番霸王条款直接成为后续一系列悲剧的导火索。为了能够让妻子得到治疗，他每天都吃最难吃的饭菜，因为价格便宜，省下来的钱就可以给妻子治疗。但仅仅只是这样，根本承担不起妻子昂贵的医疗开销，所以他便想着将刚越狱时买的基金全部提现。可林肯万万没有想到，当他与经纪人见面时，对方却给他带来了一道晴天霹雳。由于林肯所购买的基金公司早已濒临破产，为了能度过这次金融危机，他们便将这些本不值钱的债权以保本高收益的幌子卖给林肯这种平民百姓。
Unfortunate people, you told me, you promised me I'd make 8-10% of my investment guaranteed.
Jim, that's not how investment works. I mean, you gotta pay to play.
This is not a fucking game to me. This is my fucking life savings, you fuck.
Look, I understand. Hey, I feel your pain. I do. I lost a lot of money, too. But that's how investment works, man. I'm sorry. It gives and it takes away.
原以为这已经是最糟糕的事情，怎料几天后他收到经纪人的来信，令他瞬间炸开了锅。没想到此前买的基金不仅不能帮他度过这次难关，反而还出现了60,000元的债务纠纷。如今为了妻子的治疗，林肯根本无法承担这巨额赔偿，他无疑遇到了一场金融诈骗，所以他便决定找律师起诉这名经纪人。可律师开口就要10,000的律师费，这令本不富裕的林肯雪上加霜。
Somewhat ironically, unlike investing with attorneys, you forget what you paid for.
他将仅剩的最后10,000交给了律师后，对方却只是建议他最好是放弃本金，兴许能够免除巨额赔偿。然而这看似废话的建议实则一点也没有用，因为就在第二天，林肯即便同意了放弃本金，却依旧收到了法院强制收回财产的通知书。
You offered to waive my investment if I knocked off 60 grand.
That's what it was, but you didn't give me an answer in time. I have my message log first, hiring another lawyer and getting permission from the bankruptcy court.
What the fucking are you?
这名律师不仅不能帮林肯解决问题，甚至连那10,000块律师费也不退半分，这令捉襟见肘的林肯顿时气不打一处来。可哪怕如此，他也不得不到点准时上班。妻子看着林肯现在的样子张口结舌，她现在才知道丈夫为了给自己治疗已被压得喘不过气。于是为了减轻丈夫的负担，她的脑海里瞬间涌现出一个可怕的想法，她最后一次将家里的衣物摆放整齐，完事后坐在床上伸出左手，或许只有这样丈夫才能摆脱自己这副累赘。等到了晚上，林肯下班回家，他像往常一样呼唤着爱妻的名字，可糟糕的是这一次却迟迟得不到回应。林肯做的这一切无非都是为了妻子，如今妻子竟在家中自刎已没了呼吸，压死骆驼的最后一根稻草也就此落下。林肯将导致这个结果的所有人都一一罗列出来，他要让这群吃人不吐骨头的恶魔付出应有的代价。首先就是害了所有人的基金公司董事长。然后是拒绝赔付保险的保险公司高管。紧接着是坑他律师费的黑心律师，最后是那名吃人不吐骨头的债券经纪人，连带的对面看似冠冕堂皇的华尔街精英们，实则一个个也都和他那黑心的经纪人毫无两样。然而这点子弹根本不足以彻底为民除害，因此他特地多带了2枚手雷，在换上提前准备好的面具后，接下来一场惨绝人寰的屠杀即将上演。 与此同时，额外已赶来了上百名反恐特勤，正在对金融大厦进行收缩包围。浑然不知的林肯已来到了大厦顶端，他终于见到了这家啃着人血馒头的投资公司老总。
Take a fucking seat, right there. Sit the fuck down.
然而令人没想到的是，林肯并没有急着扣动扳机，而是给对方一个忏悔的机会。可都到了这个份上了，对方却还一副高高在上的嘴脸。
There's not a person on this earth that's worth over $100 million that came by that money. Honestly, why don't you take a look at the old money, the Vanderbilts, the Carnegies, the Gettys, the Morgans, the Hearsts, the Rockefellers. How do you think they got all their money?They just annexed territories and licenses and businesses and killed the native population and imported slaves and sold guns to both the North and the South during the Civil War and controlled the politicians and they're heroes, they're American heroes. And it's going to be the dumbs. They're going to fight America's senseless wars and they're going to protect American security and businesses. And it's going to be my business. My business is going to get richer and richer and my bonuses are going to get bigger and bigger. And it's the same old story. It's the bankers and the owners.And the advisors who get rich. And it's the little people who buy their stock that always lose in the end. To people like you.
眼看对方毫无悔改之意，林肯便决定来一场生意人最喜欢的竞技游戏。
You like competition?
I love competition.
You want to play a little free market competition? Just you and me?
You and me? I can't wait.
他把武器放在桌上倒数三个数，谁先拿到武器就有活下去的资格。
One, two...
Here, how I came out on top. Two, it's important. What's important is that I won. It doesn't matter. And you're dead.
I cheated too.
手拿武器的老总被视为武装分子当场击毙，而林肯则被当成了人质被送了出去。至此，影片结束。我是郑钧，主页还有更多精彩视频，我们下期再见。